Hello guys, and welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to use Font Awesome into the Scriptcase menu and the toolbar of the menu of Scriptcase 9.4. So here we go. Okay, so here I am at my Scriptcase interface. In this case I have two interfaces. I'm using the old one and the new one. So let's take a look to the new release of a Scriptcase. It's the release 9.4 number 4, right? So here we have the new interface for editing menu items. Okay, so let's go back again. Menu items here. Okay, so we have a pretty new interface over here. All right, for using Font Awesome into the Scriptcase menu, we just need to first edit the menu, then going to menu items, and then just select the item that you want to add the icon, and that's it. Then we have here the options. We have here the standard options, but remember that for using Font Awesome, you just need to go to display and select the second option. It says, it's in green right now, it says text and icon Font Awesome. So we can here pick up the icon that we want to use. We also have a filter. Then we have here the icon color. This will be the standard color. And finally here we have the disabled icon color and the hover icon color. So we have three status for this icon. And this will be a huge advantage comparing especially with images formats, because we're going to spend a little time saving the same icon in different colors. And we also need to resize them depending on your image. So this won't be a problem by using Font Awesome. You just pick up your icon here, pick up the colors, and that's it. In the other hand, you can resize the icon by using this option. You can go to layout, CSS menus, and you can change the size of your font. So this icon actually is using the size of your font of your menu. All right, so that's a huge advantage here. Okay, let me run the second sample. First I'm going to my old installation of a Scriptcase, and here I am at my menu, then toolbar, and we have this interface. So I want to show you the new interface of a Scriptcase, how it looks like. So I can go here to toolbar. This is the new interface for editing our buttons. All right. So let me show you the new features. So we can go here to display, and here we have the standard options, all text, all image, text and image. But we have the latest two, only Font Awesome icon or text and Font Awesome icon. Okay, we can choose the second option, and here we're going to see the new options. All right, basically are the same that we used in the menu. All right, the icon pickup option. We also have here the position. We do have here the color, hover color, and disabled color. In the other hand, we have here a new option available here in this toolbar option. It's the CSS style. So basically here we have different types of styles into one option. You can go here to layout, CSS buttons, and you will see different options for customize your font colors and different status of all your icons. So basically we have here some default options. For use them, I recommend you to first go to layout and then CSS buttons, all right? So I use this default option, all right? Then in the toolbar, we have the same options that we have in the grid. This is a new option that comes with Scriptcase 9.4. It's the group by option. We can have here, for example, button number 2 and 3, could be the sub item of the button number one. All right, so we can click here in the drop down option or side by side. So let's choose this option, side by side. Let's run our application, and we will have here the sub items side by side. Okay, so this is really interesting. In the other hand, here we can change again to drop down. We can run again our menu and see how it looks like, and this will be our drop down menu. Okay, it is the classic option. Okay, all right, so finally I will show you a sample using this phantasm settings. All right, I have here three options, menu and trim menu. So let's go first to the trim menu, and here we have the standard script case trim menu using phantasm. All right, the settings are exactly the same that we used in the standard menu. Okay, then we have the standard menu, so let me run this sample, and here we have font awesome applied into the icons of the menu, as you can see here. We also have a toolbar with different styles applied, as you can see here. We have this Excel, Word, and PDF file using the side-by-side option of the toolbar. And then we have here the settings, which is a drop-down menu, okay? So we have here different settings applied into this sample. Another interesting thing we can see here is that we're using tabs, and these tabs are also using Font Awesome, all right? So let me zoom this application the maximum as possible. This case will be 500%. And if you pay attention here, we are not losing quality at all. So let me compare this window with the standard images of Scriptcase. And if you see here, the images are not with the standard quality that we want, okay? So that's a good advantage as well. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. So please thumbs up, and I see you in the next time.